So I thank you for having us. I'm here with my colleague Remco, and the reason that we're together is that we probably will work very closely on this project. I'm the director, he's the project manager, so you have the hierarchy in place. We are Bureau Europa, and it is as if we have coordinated our presentation, because it also starts a little bit about the city of Maastricht. We were founded as an annex of the Netherlands Architecture Institute in 2006, and one could say that we deal with architecture and design in the broadest sense of the word. So we like to think of it as the design environment, so it's not only materialization but also immaterial structures. So just, you know, like, why are we at this table? So I also particularly like to thank Irene for this invitation to join in this very inspirational context, Maastricht. I'll run you through it very briefly because a lot has already been said. Founded as a Roman castellum, it's an important place of trade and pilgrimage. D'Artagnan, also the fourth musketeer, died in battle. Paleontology kick-started here. It was actually rather late coming to the Netherlands in 1839. Industrial Revolution started in our city, or our, I'm from Rotterdam, but home to André Rieu, you might know him, 120,000 inhabitants, one of the best and youngest universities, it was already mentioned, 12,000 students, center of a region. And because we're in architecture, also have this sort of, the city is quite dense in terms of the amount of money that come, sorry, money also, but people that come to the city.
Two things at the same.
Yeah, 20 million visitors a year, and most of them actually only come for 1 or 2 days. So maybe we can compare this with some later on the line, right?
Yeah.
Home to take off the famous.
But we don't get 20 million people.
Not yet. No. More city branding. And of course, the reason that we're called Bureau Europa is because the Maastricht Treaty was signed exactly this year, 25 years ago, in the city of Maastricht. So, understanding the Netherlands in context to our region, this is where the jobs are, in the left part. That's only when you think of the Netherlands as through the lens of the nation state, and through the lens of the center, we call it the Randstad, around the city. But of course, if you think of it as a region, you get to the latter image on the right. I've selected a few projects to give you a little bit of an insight on how we work. I'll keep it short. I have 100 slides. I won't show them all. but for instance, this was a proclamation by our king stating that we are a due democracy. So from social democracy, we shifted to a due democracy. Now I get a bit nervous when I hear this, because it is, of course, about austerity, and it's not being packaged or framed in that sense. So what happened is that we started investigating this question very seriously. What does that mean? And then it's all about citizen empowerment and citizen activation, which obviously you mentioned the new society. I was wondering what you meant by that precisely, but we'll get to that. The idea of opening this question up to a broader, really democratic situation. So one of the projects we did was, in fact, it's also kind of timed up, 5 hectares, open part in the city center, and this was just around the crisis in 2008, where the Lehman Brothers crashed, of course, and then this stagnation in both the design environment, architecture, and on many levels, started to pop up. In this case, it was an old factory. This is how Maastricht actually got its name for the ceramics. This is how the factory looked. This is, of course, the workers, very gender headset balanced, yes. And this is how we found it. And because it's a small city, and it had quite a cultural diverse, as you saw already in the presentation of Aline, there's the Van Eyck, there's Manesse, and there's Lumière. In this case, you could go to the alderman and say, could we use this for a year? Make a temporary park to investigate what a common democracy could be. These were the plans for that particular area, and we just opened it up, literally only making it accessible, making a little atrium, and we looked for funding and asked, ladies and gentlemen, what do you want to do here? People wanted to read poetry out loud. The smallest gallery in Maastricht by these young students people wanted to do guerrilla gardening. And what we would do is actually give them the seeds and then ask for one public event in return. So we play with the idea of small community, larger community, individual. There was a lot of generational exchange in this particular project. So they did a barbecue for the neighborhood, buurt barbecue, which has a nice ring to it in Dutch. Very proud of this one, the Sky Hive. We helped prototype the first inner city Sky Hive, which goes up and down. Inner city beekeeping, the second one was crowdfunded with our help. And it's now being, well, it actually worked out. And it's now being placed in Flint Park, another park. A Picnic Electronique, two young guys said we want to make a sort of mini Woodstock. And sure, let's do it. So that's outside. Outside, it's more about, about narration. It's more about, let's say, identity building, community research. I mean, we could get in deeper, right, about all these topics, but just to sketch it a little bit. Inside, we are more about a little bit, let's say, debate.